I hope you're well. So as in the title, I am going to be showing you a beginner's 10-minute workout. So I'm going to show you six moves that you're going to do in 30 seconds each move, which will total to 3 minutes. The aim is to do this little mini workout twice as a beginner. And you can obviously, if you're fitter, you can increase it, you can do more. If not, do it the once, just gradually progress. Obviously, we're in my studio. For this workout, you actually don't need any equipment. A mat would be useful, obviously, if you're doing it in your living area or wherever. However, I'm also going to be showing you some adaptions that you can add weight to. So if you find the moves a little bit easy, because you never know, obviously, beginners, everyone's different. I can show you how you can adapt it just by adding a little bit of weight. Something you can progress to, so you can still use this workout, but make it a little bit more challenging. So, let's get started. For the first round, I'm actually gonna obviously break down and show you the move, and then we'll crack on and actually do the workout. For the second round, we are gonna go flat out. So every time we get to 30 seconds, we're gonna move straight into the next move. Yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Let me know if you give it a go, and let's get started. Also, we are going to end with a little bit of a core workout. So definitely stay to the end because I can show you how you can, you know, work your core area for strength and obviously for toning. Let's get going. I've got my timer on my phone. It'd be great to have time on your phone or a stopwatch or wherever. So the first move we're going to do is jacks, jumping jacks. Very straightforward. Everyone can do this. You can adapt it in so many ways. So jumping jack. Out. To slightly modify it, you can do one at a time if you're not into jumping, but try and get it nice and quick. Also, to make it more challenging, you can add a little bit of weight. So don't go anything over 2 kilos, I wouldn't suggest. So let's get started. 30 seconds and go. Make sure you bend in the knee. Nice soft knees, neutral spine. We're over halfway. Last 4 seconds. And you're done, 30 seconds. That's how quick that is. Move we are gonna be moving on to is a squat. Okay, so you want your feet hip width apart, slightly pointed out, and you literally just go straight back like you're sitting down in a chair. Okay? To adapt it and make it more challenging, just add a weight. You can have straight arms or you can have it close to you. Right, you ready? And go. I drive my arms back and down. Make sure you try and really sit back. Bring those hips to the front. Squeeze the glutes. Kind of thrust up, I would say. I find that most comfy, and obviously it's the correct form, so you don't really want to cause any injuries. Right, we're nearly there. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Right, next move is mountain climbers. These are slightly more challenging, depending on the amount of movement you have. You could potentially use a step. If you'd rather not use a floor, you could use the edge of a sofa or a chair or something. I'm obviously gonna go straight in to the floor, but it's basically a plank position and you just drive your knees up to your chest. And the aim is just to get a little bit faster. And 3, 2, 1, go. Tuck your top in if you need to. Right, halfway. Keep going. Last 5 seconds. 2, 1. Next move, punches. So again, you want your feet hip width apart, nice soft knee. You're going to go into a little squat position and you're going to punch. Full power, tense that core. Get those arms jiggling, you want to feel it. Obviously you can adapt this by adding a weight. Again, don't go any heavier than 1 to 3 kilos. Right, let's get started. Go. Halfway. Nearly there, last 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, next move is low kicks. Pretty straightforward. You just kick nice and low. We're gonna start timer. 3, 2, 1, and go. Again, pull in at the core. Thanks for jiggling. Last 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Right, last move. We're going to be doing high knees. So like the low kicks, you want your knees to bring up nice and high. Try and get that knee past the hip, so up here. But again, do as much as you can. Ready? Last move. Go. Again, arms nice and tight. Drive it if you need to. Drive it up. Halfway already. Last 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1. That is your 3 minutes done. Have a quick drink. We're gonna do it all again. I'm not gonna talk. I'm literally just gonna bash through this workout, and this is how, once you get used to the routine, this is what you'll be able to do. Whether you can do it once, twice, three times, depends on obviously stamina and getting your recovery back. But you know, do as much as you can. You can obviously have a little break, start again, just smash it through. Remember, it's only 3 minutes. Right, we're gonna do it. Get my timer going. Gonna bash through. First one is jacks. And so when I see the timer go past 30 seconds, I move straight on. Last 10. Straight into squats. Drive up, squeeze. Nearly there. Last 5 seconds. 2, 1, straight into mountain climbers. Make sure you take note of your time. Last 5 seconds. 1, straight into punches. Last 15 seconds. That's five. Straight into low kicks. One, low kicks. Halfway. Excuse the chickens. Noisy chickens. 5 seconds. Straight into high knees. 3, 2, 1. Last move. Get those knees up. Drive it. Seconds left. Last 10. 3, 2, 1. Two rounds done. It's as easy as that. That's 6 minutes worth of exercise that you've done. That is a 6 minute workout done. Again, you can repeat this as much as you can, as you want. You could do it twice one day, you could do it three times another. Now I'm going to show you the core workout that you can do. Again, you can do this a couple times over, just some very basic moves that will help strengthen this area. So let's get started. Nice flat feet. Try and get your back flat on the mat. Right, I'm going to go straight in for crunches. So this is basically half sit up. You just draw it in from tummy, like someone's pulling you. So let's start. 20 reps. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Have a little breather if you need it. And straight back in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next move. Slightly more challenging. I want you to touch your knee one at a time. Again, we're going to do 10 reps, have a little breather, and another 10. Get ready. And go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Quick breather. And straight in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and relax. Make sure you breathe out. Right, last move. I'm going to tap the heels. So this is called a heel tap. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So with this one, just make sure your back is still very flat to the mat. It's all in the tummy. Feel it really tight here. Squeeze when you reach down. So the aim is to squeeze it. Last 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and relax. Again, you can repeat that as many times as you like. You can have a little break in between, stretch out the core. I'd recommend just bringing it to the front, just stretching. You'll feel it. It will just feel like a release. Just stretch it out. Give yourself 30, 40 seconds, a minute if you need, and then do it again. You'll see, obviously, improvements after a few weeks of giving this a go. So that is my beginner's workout. It's 10 minutes long, totally manageable, totally doable at home. whether you've got children, whether you haven't, wake up, you know, 20 minutes earlier than usual, get it done. It's such a simple at-home workout. I really hope you enjoy it. Let me know if you give it a go. Definitely stick around because I will be bringing out a video every Monday for the next few weeks, just making them a little bit more challenging every week. So yeah, hopefully you'll stick around. Don't forget to subscribe and I will see you all soon.